Good morning children, welcome back to social studies tutorial. So students, just after completing our revision session, now let's continue with this labor. So here we are going to start the next chapter of geography, that is chapter 5, the four realm or the domains of the earth. So students, before learning this chapter, you just recall the first chapter of geography, that was the earth in the solar system. So what exactly in that chapter we have learned, that we have learned about the different heavenly or celestial bodies. We have also learned about the earth, that the earth is the only planet there in the solar system because it just helps or it supports the life system. But how it supports the life system? Just for supporting the life system, three major components are required. What exactly these are? Water, air and soil. So these three components are available there on the earth. And like the earth has its different subsystem, and these subsystem are known as the domain or the realms of the earth. So what are these four major domains of the earth? These are the lithosphere, that is land, then the hydrosphere, that is water, and the atmosphere, that consists of your the different masses of the gases, and there is a narrow contact zone of all three, that is called biosphere, that is the narrow zone of contact where life exactly exists. So here, students, now first let's talk about lithosphere, that what the lithosphere is. So lithosphere, there are the two terms, lithosphere. So lithos, that means the solid, and the sphere, that is the surface. So what exactly? The solid surface layer of the earth is known as the lithosphere, and it consists of all the land masses on the surface of the earth. There are the variations of the land masses. There are the high mountains like the Himalayas, there are the valleys and the plains. So the two main features on the earth surface are the continents and the oceanic basins. Now let's talk about the continents. Students, if we talk about the continents, so the continents are the large distinct land masses separated by vast water bodies. These are the oceans and seas, and there are seven major continents in the world. So what exactly these seven major continents in the world are? These are Asia, Africa, Europe, North America, South America, Australia and Antarctica. So most of the land masses lie in the northern hemisphere. Students, now we just recall the second chapter where we have learnt about the globe, and we have also learnt about some of its parallels. And so what exactly there we have talked about the 0 degree, that is also known as the equator, which divides the globe into two hemisphere, the upper part, that is the northern hemisphere, and the lower is the southern hemisphere. So what exactly that the most of the land masses lie in the northern hemisphere, whereas in the southern hemisphere there are very relatively fewer land masses. So let's talk about the first continent, that is Asia. So student, Asia is the largest continent, and it covers nearly 1/3 of the total land area of the earth. This is the most important fact about Asia. So the entire continent lies in the northern hemisphere, and it lies entirely in the eastern hemisphere. So what exactly, if we talk about the location of the that continent, Asia continent, so what we can say that it is in the northeastern. So the Tropic of Cancer passes through this continent, and the continents of Asia and Europe are joined together and make a huge continuous landmass. So if we talk about the Ural Mountains and the Caspian Sea separate Asia from Europe on the west, and Europe and Asia together are called Eurasia. So Asia is the world's most populous continent, with almost 4 billion people living here, which is more than 60% of the world's population. So students, what we have understood while talking about Asia, that it is one of the largest continent of the world and covers 1/3 of the total land area of the earth. And second one that we have to recall or that we have to remember in this, that is its location, that it is located there in the northern hemisphere, and it lies entirely in the eastern hemisphere, that is east of the Greenwich Meridian. Now, do you know meridian? Here we are talking about meridian. So when we were talking about lines of longitudes and lines of latitudes, so now you just recall that we have also talked about meridians. These were the lines of latitudes, and the Tropic of Cancer passes through this continent. So students, this was the Asia continent. Now the next is Europe. Europe is a smaller continent in comparison to the Asia, and it lies to the west of Asia. So already we have talked about that the Ural Mountains from the easternmost edge of Europe. Europe is a peninsula with water bodies surrounding it on three sides. So here the next fact or the term which we have to remember, that is peninsula. That what a peninsula is? Peninsula is a body that are like surrounding water bodies. It's on three sides, and they are the Atlantic Ocean, the Mediterranean Sea, and the North Sea. And the Greenwich Meridian passes through this continent. So students, here we have covered these two, Asia and Europe. So we'll just discuss about the remaining continents in our next session. Till the time, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.